From Fertility Care, the IVF Center. Great to be with you all today. Just got the news that the first U.S. American woman since 1985 won the Boston Marathon. Very exciting. I'm planning to do that, to qualify, God willing, this year to run next year in the Boston Marathon. That's my promise, and you heard it here live. That's what I'm going to do. So the topic for today is mosaic embryos. I don't know how much you've heard about this, but I thought we'd talk about it a little bit. When you do in vitro fertilization, you have the opportunity to do pre-implantation genetic testing, or PGT. It used to be called PGS for screening. PGT involves letting the embryos grow to day 5 or day 6, and then removing some cells around the outer part of the embryo, which becomes the future placenta. They're called the trophectoderm. The blastocyst embryo is over 100 cells, okay? So it's removing some of the outer cells and analyzing them chromosomally, structurally. So the man has 23, or a male rather, has 23 pairs of chromosomes, 22 non-sex and then XY, and the woman has 23 pairs, 22 non-sex and XX, okay? So we then freeze the embryos and then transfer in a subsequent cycle a chromosomally normal embryo. And this is done for advanced reproductive age or for patients who have a genetic carrier problem for something called translocation, and even for gender, for selection. So what do we do about mosaic embryos? Well, what is a mosaic embryo? A mosaic embryo is where there are actually a separate cell line in the cells, okay? Not all of the cells have the same chromosomal content. So one cell could be 22XX, and then when they analyze the other cells, it could be something abnormal. So that's a mosaic embryo. And how much of that truly represents the embryo, we don't know. Because once again, the outer shell that becomes the future placenta is what's being tested, not the inner cell mass, which is the future baby. Okay? So you have a mosaic cell line. Now, not all clinics want the information on whether an embryo is mosaic or not. They'll just ask for it to be normal or not. So there are some early data in research in medical journals that people have, clinics have transferred mosaic embryos because it's either the patient's last chance or she wants to take that potential risk. What's the potential risk? Well, if it's an abnormal embryo, baby could be born with birth defects. So far, it does not appear that the embryo, if it does get born, is affected. So either there's an auto correction, or the mosaic does not represent the inner cell mass, the embryo. Okay? It does appear, though, that a mosaic embryo transfer has a lower pregnancy rate than a chromosomally normal embryo. Now, Fertility Care IVF Center does not ask for mosaic information. We have not accepted embryos, or at least have a policy to transfer mosaic embryos. This is still in development, but it's a very hot topic in our field, and I wanted to give you that information. So if you hear about mosaic embryos, you know. The standard of care right now is testing embryos, if you do that, for structural chromosomes, and they're either normal or not, okay? So, hope this was helpful to you. Wishing you a fantastic week. And kudos to the woman who won the Boston Marathon. That's fantastic. And we'll see you next week. Take care.